Hello, friends. Welcome to Tech Talks Engineered channel. Today we will discuss about SF6 circuit breaker. We will see its close and open operation inside interrupter and also a practical demonstration. In previous video we have discussed about basics of circuit breaker. For the video please click on the link given. So guys, let's start with SF6 circuit breaker. Generally 145 kV and above rating circuit breakers are SF6 circuit breaker. This is 220 kV SF6 circuit breaker, and this is single pole of circuit breaker. These are top and bottom connection palms, where conductors are connected. This is SF6 gas pressure gauge, to monitor SF6 gas pressure inside interrupter. As we know, any circuit breaker has two main components. One, interrupter, where close and open operation of contacts takes place. Two, drive mechanism. First, let's see what is inside this interrupter. Here in the diagram we can see longitudinal section of interrupter. This is airtight chamber filled with SF6 gas, inside porcelain housing. We can see two main contacts, this one is male contact which is moving, and this other one is female contact which is fixed. This is how these two contacts look like. If we look closely, we can see there are two more contacts, relatively smaller. These contacts are called as arc contacts. This one is male arc contact which is fixed, and this other one is female arc contact which is moving. This is nozzle which is made of non-metallic insulating material. Function of the nozzle is to direct SF6 flow towards arcing region, to accelerate arc quenching. These are pistons and this is piston rod. Pistons are used to push SF6, to blow it on arc, for effective arc quenching. Piston rod is coupled with insulating rod. This is how insulating rod looks like, which runs through this stack and drives piston rod and subsequently moving contacts during operation. So let's see how close and open operation happens inside interrupter. This is open condition. Once close command is given to circuit breaker, moving contacts move towards fixed contacts. Just before closing, arc is formed between arcing contacts, because distance between arc contacts is less than the distance between main contacts, arc contacts being more in length. During this operation, SF6 gas get accumulated in the region between pistons and main contact. Finally, arc and main contacts get closed, and arc is quenched. This is how close operation takes place inside interrupter. Now let's see open operation. This is closed condition. Once trip or open command is given to circuit breaker, moving contacts move away from fixed contact. Firstly, main contacts open, and then arc contacts open. Hence arc is produced between arc contacts. During this time SF6 accumulated between main contacts and pistons, gets compressed due to contact movement, is pushed into the arc region through nozzle. Hence arc is successfully quenched. This is how open operation takes place inside interrupter. Please note that arcing phenomenon is more critical and persistent during open operation than that of close operation. That's why interrupter is designed mainly to quench arc formation in open operation. How? Let's see. Because in close operation contacts move towards each other, and solid conduction path is provided for current once contacts are closed. Hence arc doesn't persist once contacts close, but in open operation, contacts move away from each other. Arc is formed and it gets elongated as contacts move away from each other. This phenomenon persists longer. Also, early interruption of arc and open operation minimizes break time of fault current. Hence interrupter is designed mainly to quench arc and open operation. Why do we use SF6 as arc quenching medium? How does it help to quench arc? Let's see properties of SF6 gas. 1. SF6 is chemically stable at high temperature, even at 500 degrees Celsius. 2. It is non-toxic and non-inflammable. 3. It has excellent dielectric property, hence it is an outstanding arc quenching medium. So because of these properties, SF6 gas is used as arc quenching medium. Now, let's see function and composition of arc contacts. Function of arc contacts is to contain arc, hence to assist arc quenching. For that purpose, these arc contacts need to have high resistance as compared to that of main contacts. Also, since arcing is associated mainly with arc contacts, these contacts heat up more, as compared to main contacts. So to limit arcing phenomena and to withstand high temperatures, these arcing contacts are coated with tungsten material. Tungsten metal has both required properties. It has high resistance, hence assist arc quenching, and can withstand high temperature. Further drive mechanism and practical demonstration of close and open operation of SF6 circuit breaker is discussed in next video. Please click on the link given for part 2 of this video. So guys, hope you liked the video. If yes, please hit the like button. For more videos, please subscribe. Thank you.